Richard Skronsky and Haku Runsman and Keith McGillivray and Desiree M.A. Okay, not right now, sir. And let me especially thank Lieutenant Governor Barbara Lawton. Barbara has done an extraordinary job for the people of Wisconsin, and we're delighted that she's on our campaign, and we thank her very much for the very kind words that she has given us. Let me begin by talking a little bit about our campaign. Our campaign started off 11 months ago, and we were at 3% in the polls. 3%. We have come a long way in 11 months. Starting off 60 or 70 points behind, we in a recent poll last week were actually 1 point ahead of Secretary Clinton. And as some of you may know, we have won 6 out of 7 of the last caucuses and primaries. So we think we have the momentum. We think we are on a roll, and with your help, we're going to win here in Wisconsin on Tuesday. And the reason why we are doing so well is we're doing something quite unusual in contemporary American politics, and that is we are telling the truth. And that is a pretty radical idea. Telling the truth. And the reason I think that a lot of politicians don't tell the truth is because the truth is often painful in our own lives and in our political lives. And it's easier to run away from the truth than face it. But what I believe from the bottom of my heart is we cannot go forward as a nation unless we have the courage to put the real issues out there on the table, dissect them, solve them, and go forward. I want to speak to you tonight about some of the real issues, issues that other people will not talk to you about. I am very proud to have been the chairman of the Senate Committee on Veterans Affairs. And I've worked as hard as I can and will continue to work hard to protect the men and women who put their lives on the line to defend us, to make sure that they get the health care and all of the benefits that they have earned. But in that capacity as chairman of the committee, I met veterans going back to World War II. In fact, we just met a gentleman in Sheboygan what in World War II. And when you realize the sacrifices that these veterans made and the fact that some of them never came home, we appreciate that they fought to protect American democracy. And the first point that I want to make to you today, not too many people will make it, is American democracy is under assault. It is under assault because we have a disastrous Supreme Court decision called Citizens United. Yeah! And what Citizens United says, what the Supreme Court said to the wealthiest people in this country, okay, you guys already own most of America, now we're going to give you the opportunity to buy the United States government. That's what they said. And that is precisely what is happening today. You got people like the Koch brothers and a handful of other billionaires spending hundreds and hundreds of millions of dollars to elect candidates who represent the wealthy and the powerful. That is not democracy. That is oligarchy. We will not accept that. Democracy is not a complicated concept. It's a revolutionary concept, but it is not radical. It's not a difficult concept to understand. What it means, you got to vote, and you got to vote, and you got to vote. And each of us has a vote, and majority wins. That's about it. Democracy does not mean that you have a vote, and somebody else can spend hundreds of millions of dollars to buy an election. Furthermore, it is not only a corrupt campaign finance system. There's something else going on around this country and here, unfortunately, in the great state of Wisconsin. And that is you have Republican governors who very intentionally, make no mistake about this, they know exactly what they are doing. They are trying to suppress the vote, trying to make it harder for people to participate in the political process. Yeah! And I believe that that is cowardly, and I believe that that is profoundly un-American. Yeah! American democracy means anything. It means bringing people into the process, arguing your case, and abiding by a majority decision. It does not mean making it harder for young people or old people or poor people to participate in the political process. I say to Governor Walker and to Republican governors all across this country, if you don't have the guts to participate in free, open, and fair elections, get out of politics, get another job. And I will, if elected president, do everything that I can to make it clear that in America, in 50 states in this country, if you are 18 years of age or older, you have the right to vote. End of discussion. Yeah. But this campaign is not only talking about a corrupt campaign finance system. We're talking about a rigged economy. A rigged economy. And what this campaign is asking people to think outside of the box, think outside of the status quo, ask questions that the media or Congress often doesn't ask. Questions, simple questions. Everybody here knows that in recent years there has been an explosion of technology and an increase in worker productivity. What that means is every worker in America, not every worker, but most workers in America now produce a lot more than workers did 20 years ago. If that is the case, why is it that millions of American workers today are working longer hours for lower wages? Why is it that all over this country, in my state of Vermont, and I know in Wisconsin, people are working two or three jobs just to cobble together some income and some health care? That is what a rigged economy is about. A rigged economy is about this country having the highest level of income and wealth inequality of any major country on earth and being worse here today than at any time since 1928. A rigged economy is when the top 0.1% now owns almost as much wealth as the bottom 90%. That sound like America to you? Yeah. A rigged economy. economy is when the 20 wealthiest people in our country, 20 people, not a lot of people, own more wealth than the bottom half of America, 150 million Americans. A rigged economy is when one family, remember, this is the United States of America. This is not some small, tiny little country. This is America. One family, the Walton family of Walmart, now owns more wealth than the bottom 40% of the American people. And here's what is worse. What is even worse is a rigged economy is when the middle class and working class end up having to subsidize the wealthiest people in this country. Let me give you an example. Walmart is today the largest private sector employer in this country. The wages paid at Walmart are so low that many of their employees are forced to go on Medicaid and food stamps in order to survive. Who is paying taxes in order to provide those food stamps and Medicaid to Walmart employees? You are. So you have the middle class of this country that are struggling, subsidizing the wealthiest family of this country because the wages they're paying their employees are so low. So I say to the Walton family of Walmart, the wealthiest family in America, get off of welfare, start paying your workers a decent and living wage. But it's not just a corrupt campaign finance system. It is not just a rigged economy. It is also a broken criminal justice system. Again, I would like you to think outside of the box, think outside of the status quo. Ask yourself this question. This is the wealthiest country in the history of the world. And yet we have more people in jail than any other country on earth. Why? China is a communist, authoritarian country, four times our size, that does not tolerate dissent terribly well. We have more people in jail than China. We have 2.2 million people in jail. We are spending $80 billion a year to lock people up. I believe it is time for major reforms in our criminal justice system. Let me give you a few. Number one. Youth unemployment in America, an issue we do not discuss at all, is off the charts. High school graduates between the age of 17 and 20, these are graduates, not dropouts. If the kids are white, real unemployment, 33%. If they are Latino, 36%. If they are African American or Native American, the numbers are much higher than that. I have a radical idea. You ready for a radical idea? What about investing in our young people in education and jobs, not jails or incarceration? I want to see those young people doing constructive work or in school, not hanging out on street corners, getting into trouble. And when we talk about a broken criminal justice system, there are other issues that we have to deal with. All of us are tired of watching TV and seeing videos of unarmed people being shot and killed. Now, I was a mayor of Burlington, Vermont. For 8 years, I worked with police officers all over this country, and I have enormous respect for police officers who overwhelmingly are honest and hardworking and doing very, very difficult jobs. But what must be made clear in this country, absolutely clear, is that like any other public official, if a police officer breaks the law, that officer must be held accountable. Yeah. We have got to demilitarize our local police departments. We have got to make police departments look like the diversity of the communities they serve. We have got to end corporate ownership of prisons and detention centers.